my method, that is fine. If you don't agree with them, that is fine. This is a method that has worked for me for many years, and I find it's the easiest and quickest way to teach a horse without using spurs and all that other bullshit. Another disclaimer, I literally just took her out of her stall. I have not gotten on her yet today, this week, or even last week. I don't even think she's been ridden in over 2 weeks right now, if not longer, due to weather. We had flooding, and we've had minor quarantine going on, so it's been a little bit chaotic here right now. So, pre-warning, I have not even been on her yet in, like, weeks since my last video when I posted about me riding her. That was the last time I was on her. So, hoping everything goes smoothly. It may not, and you guys get to watch me struggle to get on to her, because I'm so used to Simon, who is just under 14 hands, and Aloha, who is 13-something, and she is a whopping 15 hands. So, when you're used to smaller horses, it does take a little bit extra effort, so I'm just gonna go ahead and tighten my girth and hop on, and I'll show you roughly how I'm gonna start doing all this. And yeah, just before I do that, I'm gonna quickly check my battery life, because I don't know how charged it is. It's okay, honey, stay. Alright, we should all be good here, so. I already have one of those done. If you would like, I can do a double video. So we'll tack up two horses, one in Western and one in English, if that helps. The only thing is none of my tacking up videos usually have bits. She only has a bit. As I said, she's a client's horse, not mine. I ride her in the gear she'll be ridden in, so to speak. So I don't agree with putting a bit in this horse's mouth, but it is what she's used to, and I'm not going to change that method right now. So. Come on, honey. I'm still in frame. I might have cut my head off. Not entirely sure, so we'll back up a little. Back up. Okay, so teaching for neck reining, I don't use leg cues, ever. You can. I don't like to, because if I was penning or roping, I might need full force. Like, I might need my legs out, or for whatever instant, so I find it easier. You see the donkey in the background? I have no idea how the hell he got out of his pen. So, for her, what you want to do, you don't want to just turn her and then show her the neck rein cue. That's not going to teach her. You want to give her the command, and she doesn't listen, then you progress from there. So, if I want to turn her this way, I'd give her the command. See? She responded. Good girl. And if I want to take her this way, I'll give her the command. So remember, this way she's going to be loose. In this area is like our circle loop, but my camera is a little zoomed out for that, so I'm gonna try to ride up behind the camera and zoom in a bit on the log, so this can go well. Okay, hope don't bump the camera. Okay, zooming, it might make it a little blurry. That log is usually our center point. We do circles around it. That should give you guys a good enough do not bump that stand. Thank you. At a walk, I'm going to do a couple circles each way, a couple circles the other way, and then we're going to take it into a trot, because in a trot you've got to have a lot more balance into it and be able to focus on both. The horse has to focus on going forward as well as understanding what you're requesting. So you don't want to take a horse to a faster gait because they brought it down in the first one. Thank you. Alright guys, so I'm going to end this here. We're going to warm her up and we're going to come back afterwards and we'll do it in a captor to show you as well. And we'll have it on the zoomed out, so I will be in and out of frame. So